It's working.
Yeah, some days you don't feel like technology is your friend. That was today. I've tried to get this started for about 5 minutes, and it keeps saying that it's not recording, but now it's recording because I can see the red light. Hey, everybody. It's me again. I have different glasses on today. I couldn't find my utility glasses. These are my good reading glasses. So sorry for the glare, but, you know, I can see you. Well, I can see the screen, so that's good. Okay, let's get this pumped up and ready to go. I was feeling kind of sad and blue today. And so I thought, well, the best thing to do would be to make a video and say hi to my little buddies so that maybe I'll feel better. So I hope so. I hope I feel better. So what's some of the things that we were talking about last week? Let's just get right on it. We were talking about nouns. That nouns, a noun is a person, place, or thing. And that's what we have here. We still have them. They're still up there. Let's take another look-see. It says a noun. Nouns, more than one noun, is people, another word for person, one person, two people, that's what's different about that word, places, or things, or animals. We decided those were people. There's a hiker, and there's Johnny Appleseed. This place is a school, and these things, or this thing is a fox, but he's an animal. Okay, so I have our alphabet cards for today, and there's a different set because I'm trying to change it up and give you a different set of alphabet cards to look at every day, but somebody, not you, one of you guys, this was at my house, somebody took my letter A, so I'm sorry, but I can show it to you on the cover. We'll just pretend. It says here, letter A, apples are sweet. Alphabet cards. Every single one of these pictures is a noun, a person, place, or a thing. And we can say what it is, person, place, or thing, or animal. Okay, so here's our first one. Letter B. What sound does it make? B. And our sentence at the bottom. Well, first of all, tell me what this is. What is that? It's a bird. And our sentence at the bottom says, birds can fly. That's what I like about these cards. It has a nice sentence there for us so we could get practice with the sound, with the word, with naming the picture, and with the sentence. Beautiful, huh? Birds can fly. Sorry about the A. I'll find it. Somebody might have decided they were going to frame it in a picture. How about this one? Letter C in sign language. Big C or uppercase, little, what sound does it make? K. What's the picture of? Carrots. What does the sentence say? Carrots are orange. Is that true? Thumbs up. Carrots are orange. That is true. It's a good color. Here we go. Next one. Uppercase D, lowercase D. What sound does it make? D. What's the picture of? A dog. Thank you. And the sentence says, a dog likes to play. A dog likes to play. Good sentence. I like this picture. Actually, I like all of them. Big E, little E, what is our initial sound or what sound does it make? Eh. What is this a picture of? An elephant. And what sentence? What does the sentence say? I'm so sorry. Elephants are big. Is that true? Thumbs up, it's true. All of these sentences have been true so far. They're giving us a factual statement as well. Isn't that great? Here we go. Big F, little F, initial sound or sound that F makes is F. What is this a picture of? Fish. Did we get to see your fish today? We did. Both of your fish. And you know who I'm talking about, little gentleman. Fish live in water. Fish live in water. True? Yep. Factual statement. Fish do live in water. Here we go. Big G, little G, what sound does it make? G. What is this a picture of? Right. It doesn't start with a G sound. It starts with a J sound, but that's okay. It still starts with the letter G. It's just one of those strange things we have with the English language. Not a big deal. Just memorize it. It's a giraffe. A giraffe is tall and starts with the letter G. I like this picture. Big H, little H. What does it say? Huh. What is this a picture of? A house. And the sentence says, do you live in a house? Yeah, nice. It's a nice picture. Oh, next letter. Big I, little I. Initial I usually makes the I sound. Oh, excuse me. Pardon me. But in this sound, in this word, it's going to say its name because there's a little bossy E right there. Bossy E is making it say its name. So it's going to say what? What is this picture of? Ice cream or an ice cream sundae. And this says ice cream is cold. Is that true? Thumbs up. It's true. It has to be cold or it's not ice cream. Then it's just melted. It's milky. It's sweetened milk if it melts. You don't like it that way. Big J, little J. What begins with J and what sound does it make? J. And what is this a picture of? Jelly beans. Our sentence says jelly beans are small. Is that true? Thumbs up. They're tiny. It's true. But then they're so small you think, oh, I can eat more of those. I can have 50 of those. No, no. Next letter. K. Now, I would have thought this was something else because I was just looking at the picture here. I didn't look at the string attached to it, and I didn't think about the letter K, but now I'm going to. Big K, little K. What sound does it make? K. And what is that a picture of because it has a string attached to it? It's a kite. This kite happens to be shaped like a butterfly, but it's not really a butterfly. It's a kite. Our sentence says, a kite likes wind. Is that true? Yes, it does. It needs wind in order to fly high in the sky. So yes, that is a true sentence. How about this one? I said the word. I was supposed to say big L, little L. And what sound does it make? And what is this a picture of? It's a baby sheep or a lamb. And our sentence says a lamb is soft. It's true. Lambies are very soft. I got ahead of myself. Here we go. Big M, little M. What sound does it make? What is this a picture of? The moon. And our sentence says, the moon is full. What does that mean? That means we can see the whole circle of the moon. Sometimes when it's not full, it's covered up, it's half. You can see half of the moon up in the sky. No, this one's a full moon. Here we go. Big O, little O. What sound does O usually make? Ah, in this case, because it has a W with it, it's going to make a slightly different sound, but that's okay. We'll memorize it. What is this picture of? An owl. In our sentences, owls like the night. Yes, they do. And we learned that in our nocturnal animals unit, which we'll do again this year. We didn't get to do that. I think we did that last year, huh? Last year at about May. So we didn't get to do it this year. Big P, little P. What sound does it make? P. And what is this picture of? Well, one of my favorite things. And it's one of my favorite CVC words, remember? P-I-G, three letters. Pigs are pink. Is that true? Lots of pigs are pink. Some pigs are another color. This pig is pink. So, yes, it's largely a factual statement. Now, what has it been about all of these other things? Oh, let's take a look. Let me look real quick and remind us of something. We were talking about people, places, or things, right? So let's take a look at some of these. What is this? Is this a person, a place, or a thing? Well, it's a house, so it's actually a place. Let's take a look at another one. Let's look at what we just did. A pig. Is that a person, a place, or a thing, or an animal? I think it's a thing or animal, right? Good. Keep thinking about your nouns as we do this. Well, here's one that's not either of those two things. It's something different. It's something different. I'm gonna show you. Here it goes. Oh, big Q, little Q. What sound does Q make? Qu. It doesn't make it though without the U. We've got to have Q U together for it to make that awesome sound. And what is this a picture of? Well, she's got a crown on, so she's a queen. A queen is important. But what is a queen? Is a queen a person, a place, or a thing? She's one of these. She's people, or a person, another word for people. Remember, people is more than one person. Person is one person, one, only one. There's not a lot of queens, so she could be one of the few only queens. Our letter is R, big R, little R. What sound does it make? R. What is this a picture of? There's more than one name for this. We often call it bunny when we go and visit the bunnies, right? But the other word is rabbit. And what does our sentence say? A rabbit is quiet. That's true. Do they make loud noises? They do not. Do they like loud noises? They do not. They like it to be quiet or they get scared. Right? What's this? We've talked about this a lot. We talked about this last week too. Big S, little S. What sound does that make? S. What is this a picture of? Well, my phone is ringing again. So sorry. And what does this say? The sun is hot. Get to hear my dancing music. My phone music makes me dance. Here we go. Big T, little T. What sound does that make? And what is this a picture of? Turtle. What is our sentence? A turtle is slow. Is that true? That's true. Turtles are very slow. What is this? A person, place, or thing? It is a thing. Big U, little U. What sound does it make? What is this a picture of? Umbrella. What does our sentence say? An umbrella is useful. It's useful if it rains, or some people use it to shade themselves for the sun, from the sun too. But it doesn't rain too much here, so we don't use them very often, do we? Here we go. Next letter, V. Big V, little V. What sound does V make? V. What is this a picture of? It's a bunch of, you may not know this word, it's a bunch of violets, little flower. And it says violets are purple. And I'm here to tell you they are. So that's true. It's a true statement. What about that? Big W, little W. What begins with W? W, w. What is this picture of? Wagon. The wagon is red. The wagon is red. Very good. Got it. Okay. Oh. It's a cute picture, isn't it? I don't have one like that. I wish I had one like that. Big X, little X. What begins with X? And what sound does X make? X. But not in this word. It doesn't make that X sound like it does at the end of fox or socks. It says xylophone. Xylophone makes music. Is that correct? Yes. That's a true statement. Almost done. Big Y, little Y. What sound does it make? Y. What is this a picture of? Well, we're not saying the kitty. We're talking about what the kitty's playing with, which is a ball of yarn. Our sentence says, who likes yarn? Kitties like yarn. They like to unravel it. They like to play with the balls and play with the strings. And last but not least, big Z, little Z. What sound does it make? Zzz. What is this a picture of? Zebra. What is our sentence? A zebra has stripes. Or if I was British, what would I say? A zebra has stripes. That is what I'd say. But Judy, you're not British. I know. I just want to be. Thank you. Sorry about the missing A. We'll find it. Okay, our next activity. Let's go to this. This is our little folding board, and we're going to look at two different things here. We're going to try to sort. We have some flower petals that have things on them, and we're going to sort them between the two flowers. This one says letter, and this one says word. I'm going to show you the flower petal, and then I'm going to peek in here so you can see me. I'm going to show you the flower petal, and then you tell me whether it goes to the letter or the word, please. Here we go. Is that, oh, I'll try to put it so it's even. What does that say? It says sun, one of my favorite words that we've already talked about. Is that a letter? Does it only have one letter, or is that a word? It's a word. I'm going to get you started on it real quick. It's a word, and then we'll move on. I'll show you one that's a letter now, and we can see the difference. What is that? That is the letter M. It is only the letter M. It doesn't have any other letters there to give us a word. So that's going to go where it says letter. Letter. Excellent. Next. Oops, sorry. Oh, there's something. What does it say? I'll tell you, it says roots. Roots. That plants have, something the plants have that it goes into the ground, and that's how they're able to grow. Is that a letter or a word? Well, there's too many letters on that for just to be one letter. It's a word. Let's see. Let's get it over on that side. Sun and roots. I wonder if these words are all about growing plants or trees or flowers. Maybe. What does that say? Petal. That's what we're putting on this flower, is a petal. It has more than one letter, so we're going to put it on the word side. Word. Petal. Okay. What about that? Well, that's a letter U. It's just a letter. Let's put it over here next to its other friend, the letter M. Oops, sorry. I move it, then I lose some of it. Here we go. Next. Ooh, what's that? The letter Q. That's all it is. Just a letter, not a whole word. Let's put the Q up on the letter side. What's this? That's right, L, the letter L. It's not a whole word, it's just a letter. Let's put it on the letter side. Okay. Oh, here we go. What does that say? Plant. Plant. It's a word. It's more than one letter. It's a whole word. Let's put it on the word side. What about that? Water. It's a whole word. It's a big, long word. Let's put it on the word side. What about this one? Oops. Moved it forward again. Letter T. Just a letter. Not a word. Put it on the letter side. What about soil? That's another word for dirt. That's what you grow plants in. That's a whole word. It's more than one letter. So it's got to be a whole word. So let's put it on there. How about this one? Letter Y. Why? It's just a letter. A single letter. A sad and lonely single letter. Let's put it over here on the Velcro. What about this? Letter G. Is that a word? No. Say it's only a letter. A single sad letter. Oh my goodness, here's another one. B. It's just a letter. It's only a letter. It doesn't have any other letters to keep it company. Oh my gosh, that's all I'm picking. A.
It's just a letter. Oh, can I even get it in there? There we go. How about this? Seed. Oh, that's a word. That has plenty of letters. It says seed. Oh, we're almost done. Pollen. That's what bees bring over. The bees spread the pollen around to the flowers to make them grow. How about this one? Stem. That's the long, thin part that holds up the flower petals. We've done it. You've got letters and words. That was a hard one. Excuse me. That was a hard one. That's not an easy, task. But I like that one because you do have to stop and think, well, wait a minute. It's only got one thing. It's only got one letter. I can't go making a word out of it. Okay, more nouns. I'm going to go back to the old slapsy. So sorry. There's air conditioning on in here, but it kind of dries out my nose and my throat. Okay, so slapsy. I'm going to show you the picture again. This time, we're going to put it under, well, I think we don't have to use people at all. I think we're just going to have to use places and things. So we're going to look and see if it's a place or a thing, and then we can put it up on the board. You cannot see things. Let me see. I could put it behind it. Let's do that. Oh, that's better. Yeah, we're not going to have to deal with people in slapsy. So we'll just put it in front. So either we're dealing with places or things. And remember, I showed you, like, we kind of twisted it the other day. Like, we had a tent, and it could be a place and a thing. That's what we'll have to do. But most of these things are going to be things or animals or things. Mostly things. Here we go. This is you can barely see that one. Oh. I have to give you bright, colorful things. We'll skip that one. How about this? It's a penny. That, my friends, that's a thing. Oh, let's try this again. You can't really see it. There, penny. Places. How about... What is that? A leopard. A leopard. That's a thing. Put some down there. Oh, a rocking horse. Did you have a rocking horse when you were little? A rocking horse. Well, that's a thing. Or animals. See, I put animals. Look what I did. I put animals. You can't really see it, can you? Let me tilt it. Ah. Okay, so I'm putting things here and animals here. So you can see that they're two different things. And then if we find a place, we'll put it over here. But so far, I'm going to look around for a place. I guess we could take this as a place because it's a thing as well. But you can sit in this and go places with it. Nah, it's really a thing. It's a canoe. It's a boat that you can row. You can't really live there, so I wouldn't count that as like a tent. A person, place, or thing. What about this? A school bus? It's kind of a place, right? It takes you from one place to the other, so it's a place that you are in while you're waiting to go from your home, which is a place, to your school, which is a place. Let's count it as a place. It's also technically a thing, but, you know, like I said, oh, I don't know if you can see this one. Ready? Oh, what does that say? Polar bear. Polar bear. Is that a thing or an animal? Animal. That's going to go with the leopard. Oh, there's another one. What is that? Rhinoceros. Is that a thing or an animal? An animal. It's still a noun. Either way, it's still a noun. All of these things are nouns. Let's say it again. A noun is a person, place, or thing. That's right. How about this? Is that an animal or a thing? Well, it's a piggy bank. It's not a real piggy. If it was a real piggy, it would be an animal, but it's not. So it's just a thing. A thing that you put your pennies in. How apropos. How about... Oh! A bumper car. Well, that's kind of a place too. If we're going to determine that vehicles of any kind are places, someplace that you sit, it can be, oh, there's the light again. It can be a place or a thing. I'm going to have to get up. That light's just going to make me sad. What's this? That is a cactus. Do not sit there. That will give you an ouchie. It is a prickly plant. It is not a place. It is a thing. Put it in there. How about... Oh, I like this one. What is that? Tiger. A tiger is a person? No. A place? No. A thing? No. An animal. Yes! An animal. I mean, again, it's technically a thing, but you know. Ooh, here's another one. A camel. Uh-oh, there goes the lights. It's actually kind of better. Can you see that a little bit better? Let me check. I'm sorry, guys. Let me get the lights back on. I can't leave them on. It says it thinks that I'm not here anymore when there's been no movement. So if I sit down for too long, it thinks I'm gone. Camel. Is that a person, place, thing, or animal? Well, it's an animal. But it's also, this could be a vehicle too. It could be some place you ride. It can be, you can ride on a camel. That's what I was trying to say. I have ridden a camel before. I've ridden horses. Lots of people have ridden horses, but I rode on a camel and it was awesome. I had a choice between that or an elephant, and I chose camel. Now that I think about it, I probably should have gone for the elephant because it's less likely I'll ever get a chance to ride on an elephant again. They're very endangered. There's not a lot of elephants left. What is that? A place, a person, a place, or thing, or animal? An elephant is an animal too. That's right. Here we go. A tennis ball. Is that a person, place, or thing? It is a thing. It is such a thing as I have not told you before. Let's find. Oh, look at this. Does anybody have one of those? Those were fun. I used to have one of those when I was about 12 years old. So about your age, 10, 11, 12, 13. It's a skateboard. Is that a person, place, or thing? It's a thing. It's a thing. It's a thing. How about a suitcase? Well, that's another one of those where it could be a place and it could be a thing. It could be a place that you put your clothes when you're traveling, or it could be a thing that you use to carry your clothes. Either way, it's still a noun. And we still like it just the way it is as a noun. This too. It's a fence. We say, oh, it's over by the fence. That would indicate it's a place. But it's also a thing that separates yards from each other or keeps a doggy in your yard. So, is it a noun anyway? It sure is. Either way, it's a noun. So, I hope you're coming to understand and get used to that word noun, because there's so many nouns that we need to learn how to read. And most of you have things in your vocabulary. You understand what it is when I show you a picture, right? You say, oh, I know what that's for. I've used that before. I know what that is. But we might not know the word for it, or we might not I mean, we might know the word, but then we also, we might know not know how to read the word, and we might not know how to say the word. So that's why we're practicing nouns. Nouns are going to be the thing that you're, oh, there's another one. Hey, that's the one I said was a place. Tent. It's a place. So lots of words, knowing lots of nouns is going to only be helpful for you, because books that we read and when we go to the restaurant to order food, or you go to the grocery store to buy food or buy things for the house, those are all nouns. They all have names. They have fancy names, but basically they're all nouns. So if you go to Walmart, you could buy a toaster. If you go to Sports Authority, you can buy a whistle. If you go to Home Depot, you can buy some keys. So you need to be able to say what it is that you need to get, right? If you go to Staples, you can buy a rubber band ball.
Maybe.
If you go to Rite Aid, you can buy a bandage. If you go to if you go to Bed Bath and Beyond, you can buy a scale. Is that enough for today? Ah, you guys, thanks for spending some time with me. I hope you're having a little bit of fun. I'm having fun. It's better for me to stop and talk to you guys and make myself feel a little bit happy than to be sad and missing you. Because that doesn't feel so good, does it? But I do miss you, and I can't wait till we can be in the classroom again. I really mean it. I wish all of you were here and I wasn't all alone in my room. Well, hope you guys are doing well, and hope you watch this, and maybe I'll see you again tomorrow. Bye.